Well, first of all, it's always been unexplainable.
You know, it's a shared experience.
Field day is this moment in time where women are good to each other.
It's even hard to explain the spirit at Marian.
Any shared experience creates memories.
Field day is the most long-standing tradition at Marian. It is probably the hardest tradition to explain because you have to see it to understand what it is. I think it's the most real-life teaching thing that we probably do. It's fun, it's stressful for the girls. They prepare for weeks ahead of time. Every single girl in the class participates. They plan, it's all their event.
It feels amazing, we work so hard, and it just pays off. I've never been to Miami in my entire life, my whole life!
Having field day, despite a pandemic, shows that Marian girls are problem solvers. We're solution-oriented people. We can do this. We have worked around every obstacle thrown in our path, and that is a life lesson that every student will take away from Marian. So I think that says something about the soul of this school.
Why did you start? Because Sister Marcella wanted to have an outing for us.
She was thinking of bringing each of us to being well-rounded people. And part of that would be coming from Iowa and the fields and the farms and everything that was up there, to giving, you know, city kids a chance to be out in the outdoors.
You know, the sisters are way more forward thinkers than sometimes they get credit for. And they're way more radical than people imagine as well. They had the confidence, the sense of humor, and the energy to dress up in costumes, adding to their full habit. I think that says a lot about their sense of humor and willingness to participate and support.
So we had actual track and field events. Mm-hmm. We had high jump, broad jump, discus. We did all of those type of events in the morning. I think we had a tug of war.
Tug of war. We also had like a wheelbarrow race, I think, and a gunny sack race.
Right.
And after lunch is when we had the big softball game.
Right. We had field day all day long. Mm-hmm. Not this done by 11 thing. We all day long.
So what the girls were mostly interested in was who was good in baseball, who was good in softball, who was good at tug of war.
Mm-hmm. And you have to realize that all of this for field day for us was before, I believe what they call now Title IX was passed. Mm-hmm. And so we didn't have competitive sports or anything. So that was why probably field events were important. That's probably why we had a certain level of competition, but not like the competition you have when you have structured sports like we do at Marian now. With the Class A sports and everything. So it filled a need for some kind of just physical activity, sport activity, and fun, and esprit de corps that has been passed on. It's evolved, but that's good because it evolves with the times and with the people who are there. And, you know, it's only limited by the creativity of the people who mm-hmm. participate and then the rules of the administration as they've grown.
This is our page. Daisy hopes grow to unanimous win. There you go. Oh, I was on the float. We built the float in my garage, and a two-car garage. So sorry, Mom and Dad, they couldn't park the car there. But we had, so it was chicken wire and thousands of napkins.
We kind of, as a class, started floats that mm-hmm. gradually got out of hand.
I mean, every year you saw something and you kind of expanded on it if it fit for you.
And we were creative. We just came up with ideas that fit our theme.
And those floats weren't small ones. I mean, they were huge, like you'd think of any float. And to, you know, it takes an awful lot to stuff into a float.
I don't know where we got those table napkins. I hope the statute of limitations has passed that. I think some people maybe might have taken more than their share of napkins at a restaurant or two, I don't know.
So we got wind that one group would go into one of the fast food restaurants, and they always have extra napkins, so they would take the napkins home with them after they finished the meal until the restaurant people got word of, began to wonder where all the napkins were going.
Some of the best parts, I think, were marching down military to the park, and just everybody enjoying each other's company. Yes, it was competitive, but it was fun.
I always remember walking down military thinking, wow, I'm in the middle of the street.
And can you remember the people standing along the way watching us go
Yes.
down? We had a regular cheering.
All of our parents and everybody was, you know, cheered us all the way down to the park.
One of my favorite parts, parading down, half the street was blocked off, people getting mad because they couldn't get through.
Well, when we talk about marching down military to the park, military didn't look like it does now. It was a little brick road.
That parade down military, unless you were there, you will never know, no one will ever know what that was like. It was incredible. So you saw the kids coming, the parade coming from the time it left the parkway here to Benson, and that's when all the police are around and traffic is stopped. I mean, stopped on military, and you know what military is like. All right, traffic is stopped for quite a long time, but they even announced it occasionally on radio that that was happening. Yeah, it was something.
I'm just thinking of all of the times when field day is just kicking off, everybody's paraded into whatever venue we've ever been in, and you know, everybody is chanting their class colors and, you know, just cheering, and it's just four grades just completely entranced in that one moment.
You get used to something, you enjoy it, and then it changes. So I get used to it and enjoy it as well.
Good morning.
Good morning.
In the fall of 2006, there was a fire at Marian during freshman retreat. It was an accident, a candle overturned, and it caused pretty significant damage to one classroom on third floor. And then in addition to the damage to that classroom, it caused like smoke damage to most of third floor. So it really kind of made that part of the building off limits for a few months. So it was a pretty big deal here. The school remained open during the kind of the recovery process, but it was a big deal. And so the fire sort of forced us to reevaluate a lot of the things we were doing in the school. We looked at some of the events we were doing, some of our policies and procedures, and we did some of that internally, and I think some of that was done in consultation with the fire department, you know, just kind of looking at what can we do to become a safer environment. And so one of the things that came up was field day, and in particular, the way that we did what we called walls. So walls was one of the committees of field day, and it basically, you know, they would literally cover the walls and the ceiling and the floor with paper. They would build these three-dimensional objects made out of cardboard and chicken wire and all these things. And then we would open the building up to the public, and hundreds of people would parade through the building over the course of a night, over, you know, 3 or 4 hours one night, and they would look at all these things. So on that particular night, it was really a fire hazard. It was very crowded. There was no air conditioning in the in the hallways at that time. It was hot. It was not safe, really.
Walls used to, you know, actually be in the halls. It used to be halls, not walls. And that was a big deal, but freshman year you get stuck with the worst space. So we got stuck with this, I can't tell you now because it was freshman hall, which doesn't exist, but it was freshman hall. And then sophomore year we were in the basement, and that was the long, long hall. So that's even harder because you have this huge space to cover. And then junior year was from the office to the end, And that was like the prime space, because you also got the front office foyer. And so you had this whole open space in the front, which was cool. And then seniors was upstairs, if I remember. So, you know, the halls were a big deal, but every locker was supposed to be decorated. The ceiling was decorated. I mean, it was a big, big deal.
I was the student board moderator at the time. And so we decided, well, we have to rework this. And so we basically had three goals that we were looking at. The first was, well, you know, we're not going to get rid of field day, basically, you know. So we decided that we need to come up with another activity that will occupy about the same number of students that were on the halls committee. So we need that. Secondly, we need an activity that will appeal to students' artistic and creative sides, because students who signed up for that committee were the students who loved to draw and paint and build and do those things. So we need to do that. And then third, we need an activity that will satisfy our safety and security. And so we decided to use PVC pipe as our material and to build a frame that would become, we were likening it to either kind of like a life-size diorama or almost like a department store display window. You know, that, you know, those beautiful display windows in New York City that they decorate for the holidays, you know, that it would be something like that. So instead of walking through the hallways, people would walk past them.
Well, pick me up with golden hand on the sail, on the tail you run.
So my senior year is actually when we started Walls. And I was talking to one of my coworkers early today, and it brought back all of the memories of trying to figure out what Walls was going to be. I was on student board my senior year, and everyone was like, no pressure, just, you know, this has been a tradition for like 30 years, so figure out something to replace Walls. I'm very excited that it's lasted this long and hope that it continues, because I think people really enjoy it. It's obviously a different experience than Halls was, but I think it was one of the best options as far as doing something different that we could do and something that was significantly safer.
People don't understand that it's something you do in such a short time. Like all those walls outside built in 2 days. Our demo can't be sent out until the week of. Everything that we do this week is done within just a few days. And so it's crazy that we can all come together and really get into it, because it's something that's like nothing else you've ever experienced, but it's something that brings you so much closer because the people that are involved in it understand what it means to really care about it.
Tuesday night, Walls are open to the public. Wednesday morning, the classes come in and just destroy it all. Yeah. Tear it all down, clean up the gyms, and in less than an hour, everything disappears. It's as if it was never there.
You're the key to the success of the first song. Screw up the first song, your demonstration's dead.
No laughing, everyone be quiet.
Once something gets embedded in this building, it gets known as tradition. And it's really hard to end that.
We'll just take our hands like that.
Also, the song is... Huh?
Yes.
So you can like have I think we could do a jazz.
So demonstration to me is a fancy marching band experience where you get 175 young women to create a story while in motion, while singing songs that have been created out of existing songs and change the lyrics, which to me is a lot of a lot of moving parts there. So there's the band formation piece, there's the remembering the songs, there's the figuring out where you're supposed to go next. And then that's, you know what I love about Field Day? That's where you find your leaders who, like, the girls who are on top of it, getting the other 28 girls to know what the next song is.
So on demo, we basically designed the mass demonstration of all the classes, design the songs, and make the dialogue for both the class and the cheerleaders. It's actually really complicated. We do weeks of preparation, but this year we had a really committed committee, and the girls really respect us and trust us.
First of all, they have to have a commitment to doing a lot of hard work. Secondly, they have to be willing to tackle the task of dividing up and picking out a song that is really, really effective. And then I make sure that I keep saying to them, make sure that you syllabicate all of your words so that you have words that fit the notes in a very direct way. And just make sure that your first song is excellent and your last song has to be superb. It has to be the culminating activity that will sell the judges that this group of people deserve to win.
We start with some people kneeling, some sitting, and then the back row standing, and we're facing out, and then we move into a flag for the freshmen, a pirate flag, the inside cross and make the pirate's crossbow, mm-hmm. and then we are going into a compass for our little sisters, mm-hmm. and the inside will propel, and then the cheerleaders are going to point at the arrow when we find our cow from the sophomores. And then we are moving into lemonade, and the lemonade is going to pour into the smaller cup once the juniors help us out. And then we are ending at our rodeo, and we are going to have some cows in the middle.
I think that the capacity that I have is to give the kids some ideas as to what they might want to do, and then to yell at the class a lot. To make sure that they do what the group wants them to do to become really successful. So I think that's really my position. I don't write anything. I sometimes come up with formations. This year I did not have to do any of that. And then I just tell them what I think is working and what's not working, and then they have to make a decision on whether or not, from their viewpoint, if it's working or not.
So for field day, there are five committees, and one person goes for judges booklet, one for costumes, one for demo, one for mascot, and then two for walls.
Being a leader for field day is actually really exciting. People look up to me, people respect me. I bring the energy to my class when they're feeling down. I encourage them, like, guys, we got this. It honestly brings me a lot of purpose. Because at least, like, when I get up in the morning, I know that people count on me and that I need to be there for them, and they have my back, so.
Freshman year, actually, we didn't do class elections until after freshman retreat, and freshman retreat was more like just scouting out people who you think would be a good fit, but you didn't, like, choose people to be, like, nominated. You yourself ran for class officer, and then your classmates would vote for you or not. Yeah, after elections, there will be six of you who would have been chosen to be your class class's officers. I ended up being the class moderator for judges booklet, and that's kind of like a low-key committee because it's creating an object that represents your class's theme and spirit, and then along with that goes a skit that also goes with your theme.
It's like everything with field day. The name does not show what is actually happening. It's like a mini little miniature field day icon. I mean, we almost need a judges booklet museum at Marian, class by class. I mean, they are works of art. They are incredible.
All right. Huh? Just sing the leper song.
I don't think so.
Smile.
Wave. Sophomores are going to win field day.
Woo!
Yeah,
we don't. It's too early. My bowl's are ready.
Come on, weekend! Back to back.
It's rolling.
Hi!
Show us your spirit! Come on, your spirit!
amazing. Because the first time I said, what's that? They said, judge's booklet. I go, that's not a booklet. They're like, I know, they're very creative. I mean, I feel like they should be given to like children to play with because they're so cool. And the detail, the level of detail. I mean, don't you think your kids would love to play with this? And look at these little pigs in here. Look at those sweet little pigs. Look at, was that yours? See, the little, all the details, the actual little books on the side.
So it's like, it's awesome. What's the name?
Gotta go.
Okay.
Yeah?
So I'm gonna have 419.
Yep.
Where's group 10?
Right here. In front of
us. So you're here.
After every work does one, see you sail into the setting sun. We laughed and cried, but all the freshmen know.
Free the foggy, don't cry. Free the froggy, goodbye. Did you train that takes me? Wave me, you'll never know how sad it makes me. Kiss me, Frida, and then kiss me over again. That's
you
part.
Remember that.
I was 14 years old, and now I'm 56. So yeah, that's kind of scary.
Well, in 1977, the kids had to learn demonstration on their own in parking lots at night throughout the city for that month. They never got time in school to do that.
If it's done right, and I've noticed over the years, if the demonstration is built around the mascot, that helps the demo a lot and it's much more exciting. But some years when they put the mascot to the side and it's not central to the demo, they don't tend to win. And Mr. Baker, when he would do demos, the mascot was front and center. And that's a big plus in winning. But in building it, if you have good people who know how to use tools, it's just fun because it starts the first day they construct it. The second day they're painting and putting the whatever the skin is on it. Like 1 year, about 6 years ago, they built a fish and they made scales out of paper plates. And it looked like a real fish. So then they make the scales. By the third day, they're painting, and the fourth day, they finish the touches. So if you have a good crew who are working hard, they get into it a lot.
My first year when I came here, I remember thinking, oh, sure, field day. They do this all during school now. It wasn't like the old days. I mean, I went totally into old woman mode. It wasn't like the old days when we used to steal napkins and build floats, you know. And I walked in, I thought, I'm going to go walk around and see what's going on. So I walked down, and I truly expected everyone to be messing around. I did, because I kind of had it in my head, you know, this needs to get outside of school. This is a lot of wasted school time. And I thought, I'm going to, you know, watch it. My first year, I watched everything. So I went into my first classroom, and a girl with a clipboard stopped. There's music playing, and I remember thinking, oh, sure, see, they're probably having a dance party in here messing around. I step in the doorway, and there are 9 sewing machines lined up. There are stations where girls are cutting things out. There's another station where girls are pinning things together. And then girls on the sewing machine like would reach their hand back, grab whatever garment it was, bring it forward, boom, 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 right through the sewing machine, throw it in a basket. Then there was a group of girls with a basket. There was one girl with a clipboard. And she stopped and looked at me and said, can I help you? I said, no, I'm just watching what's going on. And I thought, okay, they are not, I mean, there was no chit chat. There was no, it was like, I need more material. I can't find my scissors. We need 17 more of this here, 14 more of that there. So then I'm thinking, okay, this is pretty amazing. I mean, by the time I got down to the gym, I was impressed beyond belief. I thought, well, I was totally wrong. They're not messing around.
I think field season has a soft start at Walkathon because that's
like intense feeling like you're creating your stake in the game, like wanting to get the best order at color block, essentially. I think hard start is color block right around spring break. Everyone's drumming up their theme ideas. There's rumors flying around about what everyone's going to do. And it's kind of like as the weather starts warming up, the energy starts picking up. And that's something like I feel even as a like alumni. I will just be driving around with my sisters or my friends from Marian and the springtime just feel like, doesn't it kind of feel like we're on our way to buy all the keds in the Omaha area right now? Like, I think field season is that like grass kind of starting to turn green late, early mornings. Like if I'm ever up early in the morning on in like April, that feels like field day to me. We had cheerleaders like you do now. The cheerleaders were usually in the opposite colors or something to coordinate with the theme, just like yours do now. Mm-hmm. We just did track and field events, not not judges' booklets and all that. That's mm-hmm. all foreign to what we did.
And cheerleaders, you tried out like the week before, maybe 2 days before, not like now where it's a month before.
And I'll tell you the second thing I'm always amazed by is the cheerleaders when they do all those fancy moves, like the pyramid that collapses and the backward tumbling flip things with people on their backs. I mean, I just like, oh my gosh, how do they do that?
Because you guys are drive each other hard and you're risk takers. And I mean, one girl in cheerleading fell because they were doing some thrower in the air, hurt her neck. She's got an ice bag on it, and Melissa's with her, and she says, hey, I just give me an extra ice bag. I have to go to track. I'm running hurdles tonight. And I was like, oh, goodness.
So then what rule came out of all of that?
We went more to dance rather than cheer because I had several complaints about safety. You know, if for cheerleading coaches, they have to have certification. They have to have first aid training. They have to have all this training, and we're just putting teachers down there who are nervous about that. They're throwing each other up in the air, upside down, sideways, no mats, no nothing. And I think the neck injury about put Melissa over the edge. So we went to more dance.
Really, you do come back and then you try to remember how you got a routine together in a week. And I never put the routine together, but the students who did, they were just so creative and clever, and then to teach it all to us. And I wasn't a cheerleader, like I didn't have any dance background or any dance, any tap, any ballet. I was actually an athlete. So it was kind of fun that I was able to like do this other side of me, this creative side, and somebody who liked to dance, but was never able to dance because I played sports.
I was a cheerleader all 4 years for field day, which was great for me because like in real life, I could never have been a cheerleader. So it allowed me to do something I wouldn't have been able to do. But as freshmen, we won cheerleading, which was sort of unheard of. I know, drop your jaw. We were awesome. So we had a lot to live up to. And so when as seniors, a senior class, we did not win field day. Also a jaw-dropping, yes, I know.
There is this angst that kids have because they put every student has put hours into the success of that. And when they don't win, how do you handle that? And how do you deal with that? I always tell my students, you learn a lot about how somebody wins and if they're gracious in that winning, and how somebody loses and are they gracious in that losing.
So going into field day, we are in charge of getting judges. That process usually starts over about spring break. And just making sure that the judges don't have any ties to any current students, so that there's no biases one way or another to make it fair for all grade levels.
Our judges this year, if you could give a wave wherever you are, Sally Bethan. Mary Kay McCarthy.
sometimes we did give point deductions if they hadn't cleaned up appropriately. So we would have to share that information with them. We tried to be transparent, but, you know, and the point deductions were so silly, and they got so mad at us. We'd say, like, there was orange paint on the sink in the bathroom in freshman hall, and they would be outraged, and they'd say, like, that wasn't us. That was somebody else who put the orange paint there, and it always just turned into a thing.
What I think is so hilarious is teenagers who are rebellious against rules. When it comes to the rule book, it's there, the letter of the law.
You know, Mr. Kesters had actually been the student board moderator right before me. I remember the first day he handed me the field day rules book. You know, today it's electronic, but that back then we used to print this multi-page document with all the rules in it. And he handed it to me and he said, here you go, here's the rules book. And I said, what are you talking about? There's a rules book?
Oh my gosh. The rules book. Look at this, 1993, the rules book. First of all, no one ever knows the actual score, which is good, because no one can say, well, we lost by 1 point. So the pointing system, scoring system has changed over the years, and I think it's probably the best it's ever been. But 1 year, it was tied between seniors and juniors, around 92 or 93. And the question is, they came to me, because I was the moderator, and they said, it's tied, what should we do? And I said, it's a tie. You have to give it as a tie for first place.
Hi, I'm in the editing booth of Mr. Video Productions. I'd like to congratulate the senior sleepyheads and the juniors of the hood on their tie for first place. I just want to express how much I thoroughly enjoy doing field day and a student board moderator. This is the fifth field day I've done. Unfortunately, it is my last, as I will be given another opportunity for next year. So I want to thank everyone for their enthusiasm, their hard work, their dedication, and for the tremendous amount of fun we have. We have a tremendous thing going on, Marian. Going on at Marian, keep it up. Thank you.
The following year, the tug of war became the tiebreaker. So that tug of war is actually really important. The thing is, we never know if that is the thing that broke it.
No, it's thanks to the seniors. It goes down your throat.
Hey, if you need a cough drop, you can find me the Vendetta, or you can
make it. I have one right now?
That whole sense of esprit de corps that Sister Marcella started is still at Marian today, and it's that whole sense of the spirit of the community of the group that's there. And that spirit was built up by the classmates that you had, by the teachers that you had. The sisters, of course, led the example, but that's still at Marian. That's what Marian is.
A field day, I think of it as a living organism. It's alive. It's got a life of its own, beat of its own, spirit of its own, all the features of it that make it grow. And it grew all right. Trees. It's going to be the biggest reason why Marian had to stop doing what we did down at Benson. We didn't have to stop it right away, but eventually Benson, the city, I guess, started planting trees on the hill. We actually petitioned and did all kinds of stuff that we could do to keep that from happening, but we eventually thought that was probably not going to really work out too well. But we still did it, and we had to squeeze in between trees and so on. But when we brought it to Marian instead, and we couldn't go to Benson anymore, now these parents wanted to come into the gym. And they came because there was room for them. But then there wasn't room for them because it became to be a big, big thing.
And parents were very upset about the fact that the gym, because of fire code, couldn't hold everybody. And so many parents had never seen their daughter at a field day, compete in field day. And so we talked about that, and actually Shayla Wepfer, who was the director of communications at the time, proposed and said, I think we need to think about a different venue for Field Day.
That we really had to, you know, put on our thinking caps and problem solve and try and figure out, you know, how can we maintain the integrity of what this event is and what this tradition holds for all of us, and, you know, take it to that next level and make it safer and, you know, make it more functional in the time period that we're in.
So my freshman and sophomore year, we had Field Day in the gym, and freshman year, you don't know what to expect. And so I just remember voices echoing and people are screaming their songs and parents wall to wall. And so that was really exciting freshman year to just soak it all in, and sophomore year in the gym as well. But then moving to my junior and senior year, having it at Sokol at Creighton, that even got filled up, and there was a waiting line to just stand and watch Field Day. So it really was, you know, you always know how big Field Day is, but going from the gym to Sokol and just having everyone surround you and, you know, you're cheering for your own class, but all the other classes as well, it just gives you goosebumps even now talking about it.
When we moved to Creighton, to their arena, I thought, oh, wow, we'll never fill this up. And now that place is too small. No, it's pretty amazing.
I have a love of intimacy and hominess. I think it's very proper to that age group of students, and it's wholesome. And I would choose. I understand all the logistics, so I'm not being critical of the decision. I was not involved in the decision to take it to Creighton. But I felt it's not for Creighton. It's not for Omaha community. It's not even for the parents. It's for the students.
I think that the category that you have now, I believe it started last year, the esprit de corps category. Mm-hmm. At first I thought, how sad that we have to have a category to get people not to be so competitive. But at the same time, I thought, wow, you're getting it. And you could see the difference between the first time that they had that category and this year. I was so proud of the sophomores. They weren't doing that well, but they got the idea of what it meant to be part of the group and support each other. Not that the rest of you didn't, but obviously they were shining in that area.
Our big sisters are really helpful.
Yeah, and like the sophomore class, like they were helping us clean up our walls and stuff like that.
Everyone, really, yeah. Even the seniors.
And I think that's an important category to have, because it brings you back to, I can't exactly explain what Field Day is like, but that's the key element of it.
Mm-hmm. That really we are one community. And I do feel like Marian girls kind of have each other's back and protect each other. If somebody from another school says something about a Marian girl, everybody kind of sits up like, leave us alone, we've got this. It's like, we can fight with each other, but anybody else shouldn't be fighting with us. That is to help with the competition piece and to take a step back and try and enjoy it. And this is fun, actually. This is fun. And appreciate the process, the friendships, the bonding, the collaboration, and the end product, even if you don't win.
I think it's a lot like being a kid and not understanding traditions when you're young. And as you get older and you come back and you see that a tradition is still alive, you have a newfound appreciation for being a part of it back then.
Well, I try not to cry every time, because it's emotional. It's really, I mean, you know what they're going through, and you know that this time is
how hard you work,
but it's fleeting, you know. It's just a small time of your life that is just filled with emotion, and I get excited for you, but I just know that it's right. try not to cry when in there.
This road, and I know that there's still a long way to go. As long as my head is high and I walk with pride, go with the strength inside, take every step in stride, no chance will pass me by. Long as I always try, won't let my passions die. And as long as I'm alive, the future belongs to me. Oh, the future belongs.
The core, the heart of the tradition remains the same. Competitiveness is absolutely a part of it, and it's important that it's competitive. The creativity, the enthusiasm, the energy, the class bonding is all part of it. If I could just bottle that all up, and it would be an incredible potion, but that's what Field Day is.
You know, I think the sense of community will still be there. I think some of the silliness will still be there. The sense of unity and togetherness, the sense of school spirit, I want that to be there.
I think that's why it's so timeless. I mean, like I said, the same two words are the same, Field Day, but the elements have changed over time. But that whole piece about being creative, it has been consistent.
I think looking back, so I've graduated 20 years ago, 21 years ago. And I think for me, sorry, I could cry talking about it. I see the future. I see a lot of hope, and I see a lot of like amazing, talented girls that are gonna go on to do amazing things in life. And I feel really proud to be a part of that.
You know, when I think about it, I think for me, the greatest value and gift has been the sisterhood. And it's come through events, you know, through classes and fun like that, but also through Field Day, through May Crowning, through the various clubs and activities, the leadership that was developed, you know, among us and within us. I'm just really proud of Marian, proud to be an alum, I'm proud to be a former teacher, and I'm proud to be a servant of Mary that sponsors Marian High School. I'm not biased, I think it's the greatest school in the city of Omaha, and I'm just so glad for. Yes, and I'm so grateful for my Marian experience.
In 2020, Field Day never happened. We got shut down in March. If we didn't have Field Day this year, I don't know how excited I would be towards the end of the year.
Yeah, for sure. Like, I felt like this whole week's just been like about fun. Yes, we've had masks and COVID precautions, but it doesn't feel like we're like trapped in this bubble. Like, we can be more free.
Like more community, and like I feel like everyone's working together for a common goal. And like I thought coming in like Field Day would be like every class for themselves, but Field Week has shown me that like every class is there to help each other.
It's a lot of spirit, and everyone, no one talks about each other. Like we're just really united.
I think that returning to Marian after COVID just shows that tradition never stops.